You ever have one of those ideas, you know, the type of idea that takes up every waking minute of your time until you do something about it? This is one of those ideas.
You see, ever since I first read about Kutikina Cave, I've been captivated by the idea of visiting it. The location alone makes this place one hell of an adventure, and the history side of it could fill up countless pages.
Kutikina Cave is a 170 metre cave, located on the Franklin River, deep within Tasmania's southwest wilderness. It was first discovered in 1977 by a geomorphology student, Kevin Kernan, then investigated by a team of archaeologists in the 80s. Excavations were undertaken in 1981, at the height of the protests over the proposed Franklin Dam construction. They discovered the cave has important archaeological deposits relating to human occupation 20,000 years ago. At a time when the annual average temperatures were around 6 degrees lower than the present, huge glaciers flowed down the high mountain valleys, and rainfall was around half the amount that we receive today. The archaeological evidence showed that this was one of the richest artifact deposits ever found, not only in Tasmania, but Australia. Over 250,000 fragments of bone and 75,000 stone artifacts were recovered from a 1 cube meter area comprising only 1% of the artifact-bearing deposit inside the cave. The main prey species represented in the deposit was Bennett's wallaby. Quartz and quartzite were the main stone artifacts, along with Darwin glass.
So how do I intend on finding this cave? I'm glad you asked, but first I'm going to need a pack raft.
Cool. Estimated delivery, Thursday the 5th of March. Just in time for Friday, the 6th of March, where I leave work in the afternoon and travel the 200 kilometres down to Strawn, set up my boat in the water and crash out in the car for the night. Saturday morning I'll leave at first light, sailing 35 kilometres south from Macquarie Harbour to the mouth of the Gordon River. I then cruise through the Gordon 15 kilometres to Expectation Reach, where I leave my boat and continue the journey on foot. The track I'll be walking is called Eagle Creek Track, and it's about 9 kilometres through dense southwest rainforest. Once I reach the Franklin, I'll stop for the day, set up camp and sleep. The following morning, Sunday, I'll pack up my camp, blow up my raft and begin my first leg of the pack rafting journey. It's about 9 kilometres downstream to Kutikina Cave. The exact location is unknown, but I believe it's somewhere located inside this bordered area. Once I find the cave, I'll check it out for a bit before continuing south down the Franklin. Pull up just before the Franklin meets the Gordon and set up camp for the night. The next morning, Monday, we'll check out Sir John Falls and spend the rest of the day admiring the beauty of the Gordon and the raft as I drift back to the boat I left at Expectation Reach.
And if I've made it back alive, I'll probably have a beer or two before spending the night on the river and heading back to Strawn first thing the next morning. The day has finally arrived. It is Friday the, 6th of March. And the pack raft's here.
Little unboxing, eh? Repair kit. Gonna need it. Hopefully not, actually. That's the raft. That's some other shit.
That's it. Pretty happy with that. I'll pop this in here. Time to hit the road to Strawn.
City of Strawn. Welcome to the town of Strawn, y'all.
Morning, guys. Saturday, the 8th of March, or the 7th. I don't know. Lose track. I just had to go into a quick little shop, pick up some chargers for the port in the boat, and we're about to leave. Got her all set up. A little test run on the engine before, put the the mast up. It's pretty breezy, like it's very breezy. It must be about 20 to 30 kilometers southerly winds at the moment, so it's gonna be a pretty rough ride to get down to the Gordon. We'll make it.
Okay, that's not gonna hold the rope. That should. Think I'm in the right spot.
Should stay pretty cool there. Fuck, it's slippery. I've been walking around for fucking 15 minutes and this is the first sign of the track, but I don't know, like everything's so dense. I can't imagine where to go. Just been walking around for like half an hour trying to find the start of the track, and I don't know if this is it. I fucking hope so. I hope it's not just like a toilet track, but it seems like it's pretty clear. Yeah, that must be Eagle Creek there. Right, so where I put my beers is not Eagle Creek, it's Shit Creek. That's why the water looks so crap. Bit of cool history on this track, guys, is it was cut by James Calder almost 200 years ago in 1840 for the governor of Tasmania, Sir Franklin. He was a bit of an explorer himself, and he was interested in what was down here in the southwest, so he got the man James to come through and cut the track. It took him a couple of years to cut it. This is actually only the tail end of the thing. It was from Lake St. Clair to the Gordon River. And all of it, bar the Gordon River to the Franklin, has been swallowed up. This is the last remaining part of the track, so it's a privilege to actually walk along and experience it.
just come to the realization that this probably isn't going to be like one of my most cinematic videos. Well, I've only got one GoPro battery. I was going to buy more, and they were due to come in Harvey Norman, but they never came in. I do have a battery pack, but for some reason my GoPro battery died last night, so I had to recharge that this morning. I had to recharge my phone, and I was going to top up the battery charger on the boat, but that was dead as well. It was an overcast day, so the solar panel didn't charge the battery. So basically, I've got sweet FA batteries. Well, I've got enough, but I just have to be conservative, you know, or whatever. I'm loving this track anyway. This is out of this world, this track. Probably one of my favorites so far. It's rough, but it's also pretty straightforward. Yeah, so I'm enjoying this. Oh, chewing pines right here. How sick. Lost again. Wait, is this it? This way, marker. Right, no dramas, staying left.
This is pretty depressing, so that's how much I've done. About a quarter, and it's nearly 5 o'clock.
Made it to Pig Hill.
Carnage.
I try going straight. I just wasted half an hour trying to bush bash through. Oh man, this track is hairy as hell.
Now I'm lost.
This part of the track is like literally a maze because you don't know if you're on the right part, and there's multiple ways you can turn.
This can't be real. Serious?
Another maze. Don't do me like this. I need to get to a creek because I got no water left. Oh, hey guys, I'm calling it. I screwed up a couple times and got lost. Well, not really lost, but I mean, I thought I was on track, and you just not for ages until you find another one of these things. The orange posts, but they're very rarely within sight. Like there's only been probably 4 or 5 that you can actually see. And when you do, they're like really close. The other ones are just like 500 meters apart or something. And I mean, obviously in this bush here, you can't see it. Yeah, it's pretty, I'm just so exhausted. This is where I've got to set up my tent. Yeah, you can barely see it, but it's just no flat area around here. And I want to sleep next to this orange post so that I know at least I can get off on the right foot tomorrow morning.
Good morning. Day 2 of the adventure is about to begin. Now, I don't know if this button grass kind of scrubby stuff gets any clearer. There was a track cleanup organized for this track in 2019 by Wild Care Tasmania. That was in April 2019. So I was under the impression that this track would be fairly straightforward, and it's not. So my theory is that they didn't get very far on the cleanup, and that leaves the rest of this track bush bash. The game plan today will be to get to Wattle Camp Creek, and then from there I'll make a call.
I made it through all the button grass and I'm just cruising now in the direction to the creek. Whether or not this is the track, I'm not too sure. It's some sort of clearing. Every now and again, it kind of resembles a track. Yeah, we're on the right track. sick. Current track report. Wattle Camp Creek, ladies and gentlemen. I would have loved to have stayed on this rock last night. It's so flat, it's perfect for camping. I'm pretty stoked how this is looking because we're there. And to get to the Franklin, which is here, we're gonna go up this hill, but then it's all downhill to get to the Franklin. Look what I just found. I'm pretty close to the river now, like very close to the river. I don't know what this is, Barzakoff. Ah, maybe it's an old sawmill thing. Trees growing right through the middle of it. All right, let's get down to the Franklin. I've been waiting for this moment for so long. The Franklin River. Made it. Now it's time to really stand it. Looks pretty legit. Backrest, seat, luggage, super tight. Just hit the spot on the map that Kutikina Cave is bordered by. I don't know if you're going to be able to see it there. I'm right on the corner. So there's about, looks like about 300 or 400 meters of river frontage from that little border. So what I'm going to do is just, because the water's quite mellow here, I'll just cruise down and see if I can find some sort of sign or a track or something off the river as to where the cave might be. I mean, this looks like a pretty good place to check out. Seems like some sort of trail here, so I've left my boat down there. And I don't know, there's no real clear path around here, but I'm pretty sure you're not going to get anywhere going to the right. Although I could be wrong. No, I don't think this is the spot.
No, it's not here.
Well, I don't think it is anyway. The dude that I called up, the dude from Franklin River Rafting, and I was actually asking him for some pointers, and he said that if you don't know where it is, mate, you're not going to find it. So that was a bit depressing, but I reckon I will find it. Didn't come this far, I'd only come this far. The thing that breaks up a lot of the availability to search is these huge limestone cliffs, which take up probably over 100 meters of the river frontage. And I just can't see it being there, because how would anybody have been able to access it when you're faced with a big steep cliff like that? If I can't find anything down the river, for sure it's got to be part of this big cliff around and at the front, north facing. I had a bit of a look around there before and I couldn't see anything, because I basically just tried to stay within the search criteria of 35 meters back from the river and only 10 meters above. I went all the way up to 20 and 50, so I had a good decent look in there. Yeah, I'll try down the river. Okay, I'm right in the middle of the boundary. And no sign of any clear track or anything. I mean, up there might work, but that's too steep. And I just can't imagine that. That's like, that's over 20 meters elevation. But I can't see it being further down actually, because of those cliffs. This might be worth a shot here. Crap. No one's come through here in ages. Nah, I don't think it is there. I've gone away to the southern end of the boundary. So, I'm gonna say it's gotta be that first spot I was at. There's nowhere else as worn as that. It's just a matter of figuring out which direction to travel in, given the limited clues I've got. Oh, I'm way too high. But I've gone, I've stayed about 35, 40 meters from the riverfront. I've gone from up here all the way along. Nothing. I've just got to keep trying, I guess, but I just don't see how it can be on those big cliffs. Like, there's no access. And you gotta have access. I'm gonna have one more look. One more climb right to the top. Because there is another cave called Northophagus Cave that I should be able to find.
if not Kutikina.
Nah, I've searched, man, I've searched so much around here. I've been to every elevation, up and down, across, in and around, and I just can't find either of the two caves. So I'm gonna have to call it. I hate to do it. Maybe some things are better left unfound. Nice one, get your fucking shoes completely saturated. Well, that's a bit disheartening, to be honest. Thought I would have found it. I came in with a plan and it didn't work out. Guess that's how it goes sometimes. There's always a 2% chance that it is further on down the river, but that's 2%.
I'm thinking maybe I didn't give this spot a good enough chance.
Spot number two.
I mean, I barely walked up it and just said, nah, I don't think this is it.
Could actually be it. So I'm not going to leave here without finding out. I'll go up and have a sus.
Nah, see, I thought that this whole line here might have been caused by a landslide, and I was right.
Huge amount of earth's just been removed from the crust. It's not it. Hold the phone, what's this we've got here? Looks like a little bit of a track.
Let's go and investigate this one.
Kutikina Cave. Found it.
It says Kutikina is part of the strong Aboriginal heritage of southwest Tasmania and contains a large number of irreplaceable Aboriginal artifacts resulting from people living here during the last ice age. Visitors are welcome to enter the cave but are asked to assist in its conservation by staying on the walk path provided. Please do not smoke or camp in the cave or leave any litter in it. The floor deposit should not be touched or removed. Over there you can see, when I turn the torch off, you can see like a skylight that comes down, and apparently that's where they found a heap of the tools that they were using, because they used to work under the light over there. I'll take a picture on my phone on slow shutter and see if you can see it. There it is there.
While today thick rainforest surrounds this cave, at the time the cave was occupied, the area was covered with alpine grasslands and sparse tree cover. The thick rainforests were confined to the lower reaches of the river valleys, below what is now Macquarie Harbour. Large sections of central Tasmania were covered by glaciers. The open grasslands made for easy walking and supported large numbers of game animals such as wallabies. The area was part of a homeland of a small band of about 20 to 30 people who migrated from the coastal areas each summer, returning to the coast to avoid the severe highland winters. This cycle was repeated generation after generation for about 1,000 years. Then, somewhere around 14 to 20,000 years ago, the climate changed. Warmer temperatures in the inland mountains and river valleys favoured the development of rainforests, which gradually reduced the number of large grazing animals and made caves wetter, and perhaps less pleasant places in which to live. Melting glaciers cause sea levels to rise, separating Tasmania from mainland Australia and flooding places like Macquarie Harbour and Port Davey. Around this time, Aborigines stopped using Kutikina and other caves in the Franklin Valley and seemed to have made camp only in the forest from then on. Although Aboriginal people had lived in Western Tasmania for at least 30,000 years, within 50 years of the official white occupation of Tasmania in 1803, most of the Aboriginal people had been removed from their homelands and forced to live in exile on the Furneaux group in Bass Strait. Despite a battering from white society, Aboriginal culture has evolved and survived. Sacred sites like Kutikina are an important part of the Tasmanian Aboriginal community's ongoing relationship with the land. Tasmanian Aborigines were prominent in efforts to have caves such as Kutikina protected by World Heritage listing.
That big pile of stones over there is the hole that the archaeologists dug and found all the artifacts.
Well, that was pretty amazing to see that in person and to know where it is now, finally. I just can't believe the battle that I've taken to have seen that cave. It's crazy. What can I say? I made a heap of mistakes, which was all fun and games, but you gotta do it, I guess, to learn. Surprised I didn't find any other stuff on those other hills that I was exploring. I've definitely seen a fair bit of this river now. So I'm gonna make camp somewhere before the Franklin ends. I've gotta navigate these two kind of bigger rapids that are a bit dangerous, so I'm gonna head to the first one now, which is Double Fall. Shit, that's Double Falls down there. I think the only way that I can do this is if I start over here, head straight over to the other side, follow it hard left, and then I should be able to pull in to that little slow spot and then walk over that way, and just hopefully I don't get sucked down into the fall. Here goes nothing. Yeah, wow, look at that. Holy shit. That's what was coming after the other fall. All right, that's Double Fall. Done. I've only got one more nasty, and that's Big Fall. And it's almost 6 o'clock, so there's an island coming up and I'm thinking I might pull in there for the night, make some tea. Hopefully there's a bit of flat land where I can set up the tent properly, just relax for a little bit. Today's been huge, like from where I woke up from that hike
all the hiking that I did trying to find Kutikina, it just smoked me. It's been an awesome day, but I'm gonna recharge and hit Big Fall tomorrow. And then Pyangana Cave is meant to be pretty spectacular, so hopefully we'll get some nice morning light and just see what that's all about.
This is it right here. Actually a bit of sun coming through too for the next 5 seconds. But yeah, this is where I'll pitch my tent. It's not too bad of an angle, at least there's enough room. All right, got some nice warm clothes on. Got my washing line on the go. Packraft secured to the tree, drying out my mat. And then got my tent set up. It's drying off pretty well. Had so much condensation on it from this morning. But no, I think that'll be fine. I'm pretty excited for tea because I've got butter chicken and mashed spuds.
Oh, leech. Can't escape the little pricks.
But the chicken's still pretty warm. Today was a bit of a send, wasn't it? There was one point that I thought, like, I'm not gonna get there. It was when I was coming down that hill after I was talking about how it had the little up and then all the way down, and I just lost the track. It was pure horizontal scrub for, I don't know, probably 500 meters. I was climbing up over the top of the trees and I just thought, well, I'm only like 1.5 k's away from the Franklin, so I'm going downhill. I'm just gonna get there regardless. And I ended up finding the track again. But yeah, it was sketchy. There's no way that that cleanup made it that far because it was in terrible condition. Like, it was worse than Jane River track for sure. But real worth it.
Thank you.
probably should have put some shoes on.
Ah, well.
How sick is this?
Kind of hard to believe, but that's it for the Franklin. Time to say goodbye to the Franklin and hello to the Gordon.
John Ford.
There she blows.
Honestly, have you ever seen a more beautiful sight than this?
Well, yeah, I have actually. Cold.
Well, that just about wraps this video up, guys. I'm absolutely knackered. The last 3 days has been huge. hopefully you enjoyed this video as much as I enjoyed the adventure. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a thumbs up. And if you're interested in doing something like this, like, don't be afraid to ask me questions about it. Feel free to drop a comment or just contact me. And yeah, I will just say that if you are thinking about doing this, I'll leave you with these four words: you won't regret it.